creative arts are a viable option for literature students?
Obviously, I think for literature students, creative arts can do something which no other field can do. Suppose, I take an example of a play, Samuel Beckett's Waiting for Godot. Now, if you get into the dramatic society or you take up dramatists and you try to enact the character Vladimir on stage, do you think that any other student can understand Vladimir the way you will understand? Because when you get into the character, you will understand the emotions. If you read Samuel Beckett's Waiting for Godot, I am sure master's students, first year students would have read it. You will find out that the play makes no sense. But when you enact it, when you research why the characters are acting in the way they are acting, you will find so much sympathy with those characters. So it's a beautiful option. It is going to give you a totally different genre to explore. Also, at the same time, just like that Inox Cinema's tagline goes, live the movie, you actually start living the character. You start living the book when you act, when you work on that. So definitely, if you get opportunities, you should grab it. That would be the best thing.
That's great. I'd like to ask you, how do people react to your choice of literature now, now that you have cracked NET? And how did they react earlier?
Okay, so...
That's my favorite.
I know. See, in life you'll meet two kinds of people. Ek wo hote hain jo is particular professional category se belong karte hain, CAs, engineers, doctors. Ye aapko abhi bevkoof samjhenge. I'm telling you, mujhe samjha tha. Theek hai, they used to say, kya literature, matlab ye kaun padhta hai? Literature, kya novels padhte ho tum log, novels pe exam dete ho? Like, they don't know what is the depth. They have read Twilight, right? So they judge us on that basis. Okay, Twilight they are reading. Their life is fun. You don't need to do anything. Just pick up a book and read it. That's it. Give the exam. And on the other hand, you have people who are going to appreciate your career choice as well. I have a few relatives who were literature se bahut inspired the. So when they saw that I'm studying literature, they congratulated me and they asked me that, why don't you go abroad, study in Cambridge, study in Oxford. It's a beautiful field. You love so much. So you'll find both kind of people. But then now, the situation has changed, it has altered after I've cleared NET. Why? Because now I have established myself, I have reached a particular milestone. So now people know that, okay, it's not that only engineers and doctors can create a career of their own, they can earn money. Even professors, dignified professors, they have an option to make it very big in life. So once you establish yourself, once you come to a stand in your life, people will change their mindset and people are going to definitely appreciate your career choice. So in spite of the career you are choosing, if you are the best in that, there's no one who can stop you. So I think that yes, people and their views are going to change with time, but then you have to prove your worth for that. Yeah.
Amazing. What does being a Xavierite mean in the real world? Does it have any ramifications, the brand name?
Totally. Like, I think Xavier's is one such institution which is internationally known. So you always know that you feel confident when you go for a job interview and you have Xavierite written on your CV. Because that definitely is going to create a very different kind of impact. And it's not just on paper. Even your personality is affected. For example, agar aap koi Chhajjumal College se graduation karke nikle ho, so can you feel ki aap us confidence ke saath logon ko approach kar paoge ek interview jahan pe bade bade colleges se log aaye hain, wahan pe aapki knowledge hote hue bhi you might feel you are lacking somewhere. So Xavierite hona ek bahut hi acha, I would say, aapke career ke liye ek redefining moment hai, because this is where you have a different aspect of your personality coming out. It is going to transform you altogether. Aap jab events mein participate karenge, when you interact with people, it matters a lot. See, there was this very good soft skill trainer who said that you are a byproduct of 5 people with whom you spend your day. So aap soch ke dekhiye, agar aap aise logo ke saath din bita rahe hain jo zindagi mein kuch nahi karna chahte, to aap achanak se aisa kaise soch lenge ki aap zindagi mein bahut bada karenge. I never had friends. I'm telling you very frankly, I never had friends. Xavier's mein aake for the first time, I met people I'm proud today to call my friends, because they share my wavelength, they share my thinking pattern, and that is how you develop as a person. These people whom today I address as my friends, they have helped me to achieve my goals because they were there with me. अगर मेरे साथ कुछ ऐसे लोग होते जो लाइफ में कुछ ज़्यादा नहीं करना चाहते तो मे बी शायद आज मैं भी उसी भीड़ में कहीं होती, आई वुड नॉट हैव बीन हेयर. सो इट मैटर्स अ लॉट. सी वी पे भी बहुत अच्छा इम्पैक्ट पड़ता है, ओवरऑल आपकी पर्सनैलिटी पे भी इफेक्ट पड़ता है, एंड एज वेल एज यू विल फील प्राउड टू बी अ जेवियर आफ्टर यू कम आउट ऑफ दिस इंस्टीट्यूशन. Yeah.
Xavier's develops you as a whole, so be proud to be a Xavierite. It can be argued that literature is universal, but what do you think of English literature, specifically the language?
Okay, see, English as a language is beautiful, definitely, because if you look at the origin of English language, there are a lot of inflections in the entire language system. French, German, all these languages, they have given their words to English. For example, we all literature students are very familiar with the word carpe diem. Now, it's not actually English word, but then we have adopted it from different languages. So, English is beautiful in its own way, but then at the same time, I would never say that any other language, be it Bengali, be it Hindi, is inferior. Because see, all languages are beautiful. My father used to give a very beautiful analogy that all these words of different languages, they are like pearls. आपके हाथ में वो पर्ल्स खेलते हैं, आपको आना चाहिए कि कैसे उन पर्ल्स को आप एक साथ जोड़ के एक स्ट्रिंग बना के एक नेकलेस बना के पहन सको. सो ऑल लैंग्वेजेस आर गोइंग टू प्ले इन योर हैंड्स, बट देन ओनली इफ यू प्ले विद दीज लैंग्वेजेस, इफ यू टेक आउट टाइम टू राइट और ड्राफ्ट एन एसे, एंड यू राइट और ड्राफ्ट दैट एसे ट्राइस और फाइव टाइम्स, यू विल फाइंड आउट दैट योर फर्स्ट ड्राफ्ट एंड योर फिफ्थ ड्राफ्ट वो टोटली डिफरेंट. कोई और पढ़ेगा तो वो शायद ये बोलेगा कि ये एक इंसान ने नहीं लिखे. दैट इज़ हाउ यू ग्रो, बिकॉज यू कीप ऑन लुकिंग एट डिफरेंट वर्ड्स, डिफरेंट फ्रेजेस दैट यू कैन यूज इन ऑर्डर टू मेक दैट आर्टिकल बेटर एवरी टाइम यू राइट. सो इंग्लिश इज नो डाउट अ ब्यूटिफुल लैंग्वेज. या
टोटली ट्रू. सिंस यू हैव बीन अ ज़ेवियराइट, यू प्रीटी मच अवेयर ऑफ द करिकुलम वी हैव सीन, द वास्टनेस ऑफ करिकुलम, डू यू थिंक दैट इट इज सफिशिएंट?
नॉट एट ऑल. लिटरेचर is a field which is like ocean. You can never get enough of it. I'm telling you, I am currently doing my PhD, and when I meet other fellow scholars who are doing PhD, there are scholars who are working on Hamlet from 5 years, and still if you ask them that how much have you understood this character, they are going to say we failed to understand what Hamlet is. Literature is a field like that. आप 5 साल तक एक play पे काम करो and फिर भी आपको ये लग सकता है you have not yet done justice to that particular work. और वहीं पे exams के लिए 3 घंटे में भी उस play की summary पढ़ के you can write a fantastic answer and get the marks. So literature is that kind of thing. It totally depends आप क्या करना चाहते हो. आप shortcut लेना चाहते हो वो भी possible है, marks आ जाएंगे, but you will never become a good teacher. बिकॉज आज मेरे पास अगर इतनी सी नॉलेज है तो मैं आपके सामने इतना सा बोल पाऊंगी बिकॉज ऑफ द लैंग्वेज बैरियर, बिकॉज ऑफ द टाइम बैरियर. अगर मेरे पास इतनी नॉलेज है तो मैं शायद इतना बोल पाऊँ. यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड द डिफरेंस. एक टीचर के पास अपने स्टूडेंट से बहुत ज़्यादा नॉलेज होनी चाहिए, तभी वो एक अच्छा टीचर कहला पाएगा, तभी वो एक अपने प्रोफेशन के साथ जस्टिस कर पाएगा. सो मेक श्योर करिकुलम लिमिटेड है, इट्स ऑल फाइन. हम सबकी आदत क्या है, वी ऑल वॉन्ट टू चेंज द वर्ल्ड, बट देन वी वॉन्ट टू चेंज द वर्ल्ड बाई टेलिंग अदर पीपल वॉट इज देयर फॉल्ट. सो देयर वी आर गेटिंग रॉन्ग. हमें ये देखना है करिकुलम में प्रॉब्लम है, इट्स फाइन, लेट्स नॉट ब्लेम द सिस्टम, लेट अस डू वॉट वी कैन डू एट आर एंड. इंटरनेट का एक्सेस सबके पास है. डी यू का करिकुलम डाउनलोड करने में शायद 2 मिनट लगे. आप डाउनलोड करके जितने वर्क्स हैं यू कैन स्टार्ट स्टडिंग ऑन योर ओन. वी हैव ऑल दीज ब्रिलियंट टीचर्स विल हेल्प यू आउट, बट देन हेल्प तब करेगा इंसान जब सामने वाला हेल्प मांगे. सो दैट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट. अ टीचर कैन नॉट फोर्स यू टू स्टडी समथिंग विच इज नॉट अ पार्ट ऑफ योर करिकुलम. ओके, बट देन यू हैव द ऑप्शन टू स्टडी इट ऑन योर ओन, एंड यू हैव द ऑप्शन टू टेक योर नॉलेज टू अ नेक्स्ट लेवल.
Since you mentioned Rio, I would like to ask you. Unfortunately, Rajasthan University is not up to date with the present andragogy. What can our students do to be toe to toe with their peers from DU or say MA?
See, the most important thing that Rajasthan University is missing in their curriculum of English literature is contemporary literary theories. Because if you look at Delhi University, Mumbai University, or all the good colleges across India, they are teaching ecofeminism, they are teaching queer theories, they are teaching structuralism and deconstructionism in an entirely different manner. Now, as a student, you can start with some really popular websites. That is how I learned literary theories, because in NET, National Eligibility Test, this time more than 30 questions were asked from literary theories. It is very important because you cannot understand the text unless and until you apply a theory and look at what comes out. So as a student, it is very important for you to get acquainted with these literary theories. You can get some good Indian writers' books. I would never prefer you go for foreign journals, because at this level you will not understand. I started with a book called David Deci's History of English Literature, and when for the first time I was reading it for NET, I read 100 pages and I was only able to understand one. That was my level, okay? I'm telling you very frankly. Why? Because that writer, he is a brilliant scholar and he has talked about different works of Shakespeare, but he has not introduced the characters, neither the plot. Now, if you don't know the story of Merchant of Venice and I'm giving you a paper on the analysis of the character Portia, you will not understand anything. So if you want to get ahead of the students who are studying in Delhi University or Mumbai University, the first thing that you need to do is to go to internet and research about the latest theories. There are a lot of websites like Shmoop, Litcharts, Enotes, GradeSaver, CliffNotes, all these websites, they are giving articles in a very understandable and a very conversational manner. Once you read it, you'll exactly know what the theory is talking about. What they've tried to do, they have kept all the technical jargon away and they've tried to simply tell you what structuralism actually means. It's as simple as that. What feminism it is, what are the different waves of feminism, and what is the difference between all these waves. So you need to do a bit of research out of the classroom if you want to stay ahead, or at least stay in touch with the syllabus that has been taught across different universities in India.